So grateful for this day, grateful that we were able to be gathered here for Emily's baptism, and we're so grateful for the gospel of Jesus Christ in our lives and our opportunity to become clean again, and we're so grateful for the many blessings we've been given, and please bless us that all that we'll be able to feel the Spirit as we're here, and we're so grateful for all of the things that we've been given, and the example of Jesus Christ in our lives. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, Elder Vermeeren. That was great. So we'll start with a talk on baptism by Rachel Ouellette, and then we'll have the baptism, and President Smith will be doing that. And then the witnesses will be me and Elder Sommer. And then after that, we'll have some intermediate music and go from there.
Take away the sins of the world. So
the main reason that we get baptized is to follow the example of Jesus Christ. If Jesus Christ hadn't done it, we probably would not be required to do it. But Jesus Christ was our perfect example. And so it's very exciting because today you get to follow the example of Jesus Christ. You get to do something that he did just for us. And so then the next verses are the promises that you're kind of taking upon yourself at this time by wanting to be baptized and by choosing this. So it's Mosiah chapter 18, verses 8 to 10. And this is a classic scripture, so it's an important one that you'll love a lot one day. So it says, and it came to pass that he said unto them, behold, here are the waters of Mormon, for thus were they called. And now as ye are desirous to come into the fold of God, so as you want to become a member of the Church of Jesus Christ and follow the example of Jesus Christ, and be called his people, Christ's people, and are willing to bear one another's burdens that they may be light. So you're willing to take care of people, and you do that all the time, so I'm sure you know that well. Yea, and are willing to mourn with those who mourn, yea, and comfort those that stand in need of comfort, and to stand as witnesses of God at all times and in all things, in all places that you may be in, even until death, that you may be redeemed of God and be numbered with those of the first resurrection, that you may have eternal life. So that's talking about how you're choosing to do everything that God has asked you so that you can live with him again. And then in the last verse it says, and I say unto you, if this is the desire of your hearts, what have you against being baptized in the name of the Lord as a witness before him, that you have entered into a covenant with him, that you will serve him and keep his commandments, that he may pour out the Spirit more abundantly upon you. So, because you are getting baptized, we all know the answer to that was, yes, I'm willing to do that. I want to follow Christ. But, yeah, so when you're getting baptized, remember that. Remember that it's that sacred covenant with God. You're following the example of Jesus Christ and how special that is. Because you only get to do that once in your life. You only get to be baptized for yourself once. And you'll want to remember this moment. I testify that Heavenly Father is so happy and proud of you. He's so excited for you to be able to have this blessing in your life, and also to have the Holy Ghost, which is the Spirit, and we're going to talk about more. And I say that in the sacred name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. I don't know. It looks like it's.
It was even warm when I had been baptized.
Emily Rain Purdy. Having been commissioned of Jesus Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. That was great. So we'll now have a talk on the Holy Ghost by Sister Anderson, after which President Smith will confirm Emily and then give any last-minute remarks. And then we'll have a closing hymn and a prayer by Elder Armstrong.
had made the decision to be baptized into the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I know Heavenly Father is very pleased with this decision also. I just think that we're here for you to help you as you go along that path to go back to our Father in Heaven again. So today I'm going to talk about the gift of the Holy Ghost. Before individuals receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, they first receive the Spirit or light of Christ, which is given to every person who's been born in the world. Every one of us born into this world enjoys a blessing to the light that shall never cease its drive with you until you are led to a further light from the gift of the Holy Ghost that may be received only upon condition of repentance and baptism into the kingdom of God. As you think about this, you know, we're all born, we all have a conscience. We know what we do is right or wrong. But the gift of the Holy Ghost is so much more than that conscience. It teaches us, it testifies to us. He's there to warn us, build up peace and to strengthen our conversion. So there's so much more that the Holy Ghost does. So what is the gift of the Holy Ghost? And President Joseph Fielding Smith, the prophet, in past said, it's nothing more or less than the right to the companionship of the Holy Ghost. So with this gift, you will now have the companionship to be with you as you live throughout your life. The gift of the Holy Ghost is a privilege given to people who place their faith in Jesus Christ, been baptized and confirmed members of the church, and receive continued guidance and inspiration from the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost usually communicates with us quietly. His influence is often referred to as a still, small voice. President Boyd K. Baffert explained, the Holy Ghost speaks the voice that you feel more than you hear. While we speak of listening to the whispering of the Spirit, most often one describes the spiritual prompting by saying, I had a feeling, or the voice of the Lord speaks gently, prompting in you what you should do or what to say or caution you or warn you. So just remember, when you have a feeling, that you need to make sure that you take heed to what you feel in your life. I'm going to give examples of good and bad so you can see that how important it is that we listen to the Spirit. So many years ago, we only had 2 children at that time, and we lived in southern Alberta, and my grandma wanted to go to Waterton National Park. She'd never been there before, and she thought it would be the best outing. So we packed up our 2 kids, took my grandma, my husband, and I, and we drove off to Waterton. And we went up to Red Rock Canyon, and it's a beautiful hike. We go up into the canyon and that. And as we're going along, my youngest son at the time was under a year old, and he started to cry. And so the further we got up the canyon, the harder he cried. And so we thought, okay, you know, we better not do this hike. So we turned around. The minute we turned around, he quit crying. To this day, we don't know why he was crying, but we know that we weren't listening to the Spirit, but the Spirit was working through our son. And so nothing ever happened to us that day. So just remember always to listen to that Spirit. You'll never know. Good things may happen or bad things, and that's one experience that we've never forgotten. It's been over 40 years that I'm going to always listen to when the Spirit tells me. I shouldn't say always, but I'm going to try to listen to it. Because 4 years ago, I had a feeling to call my mom one night. I only had talked to her a couple of days before, and I thought, oh, it's Saturday. I'll call her on Sunday because Sundays are such a long day for her, and I'll have a nice chat with her the next day. That morning, she passed away, and I never had the chance to say goodbye to her. And if I was listening to the Holy Ghost, I would have called her that night and talked to her. So it's really, really important when the Holy Ghost speaks to you that you listen to what he's telling you. And it might be, like with me, I had regrets of not phoning my mom when I should have, but if I would have done it. So just never, when you have that feeling, just make sure you take heed and pay attention to it. The gift of the Holy Ghost is one of God's greatest gifts to us. Through the Holy Ghost, we may know that God lives, that Jesus is the Christ, and that his church has been restored to the earth. We may have the promptings of the Holy Ghost to show us all the way the things we should do. The Holy Ghost sanctifies us with prayers for God's presence. We may enjoy the gift of the Spirit, but this great gift from our Heavenly Father can also bring peace to our hearts and understanding things of God. So like you, Emily, it was 45 years ago that I was taking the lessons from the missionaries. It's almost 46 years. And the only reason I did it is because my best friend from high school married someone that was a member of the church, and he wanted her to be baptized in the church, and she didn't want to take the lessons alone, so she asked me to take them with her. To this day, I only said I went because I had nothing better to do, but the Lord knew different. He knew that I needed to be into the church, and so as I took the lessons, we both were baptized into the church, And it's one of my biggest blessings in my life to be a member of the church and to get to know my Savior Jesus Christ. So the Holy Ghost will testify to you different things about the prophets, about Jesus Christ, about different things in the church as you will learn to grow in the church. I teach seminary, so in the mornings I teach 14 to 18-year-olds, the best group of kids. I have one of the moms in the back there. I just love this group of youth that I teach. And yesterday we talked about Doctrine and Covenants 8, verse 2. It says, "And behold, I will tell you in your mind and your hearts by the Holy Ghost, which shall come upon you and which shall dwell in your heart." The Holy Ghost is going to, speak into your heart, into your mind things. You need to do this. Well, we talked a little bit about yesterday, and they weren't quite sure. One of the youth wasn't quite sure about it. So I tried to explain to him that when you pray about something, that when you receive the answer, it's going to come into your mind or into your heart. So it's really important that you pay attention to it all. So the accompanying spirit of the Holy Ghost can abide with us 24 hours a day when you work, when you play, when you rest. His strength and influence can be with us year in and year out. The sustaining influence can be with us in joy and sorrow, when we rejoice as well as we grieve. I am thankful that I am a member of this church. And as my testimonies is strengthened in different areas, this year I've taken the time to strengthen my testimony with our Savior Jesus Christ. And I've read so many books and prayed and all that. And I feel like I'm beginning to understand what the Savior's done for each and every one of us. And it's a lifelong process to continue to study. And the Holy Ghost will testify to you. Yesterday I was doing a lesson I'm going to be teaching next week about Doctrine and Covenants 135, about the martyrdom of Joseph Smith. And as I watched a video, I just had tears streaming down my face, realizing what Joseph Smith has done for each and every one of us. And I'm thankful that he restored this gospel in these latter days, and that I could be a member of the church. And now, Emily, you're also a member of this church. Just remember the other, couple weeks ago when we were playing volleyball here at the church for a family home with me, and how much the youth in the branch were helping you as we played volleyball. Just remember those youth are here, and they love you, and they're going to support you as you go continue on in the gospel. And I say that in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Restarting the Zoom. How the time though?
Well, we won't be broadcasting this. So.
Okay.
Sister Emily Rain Purdy. Through the authority of the Holy Melchizedek Priesthood, which we unitedly hold, we lay our hands upon your head and confirm you a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and say unto you, receive the Holy Ghost. Sister Purdy, what a wonderful act you have. Cold as it might be on the outside, it is so warm and welcoming. You profess now here your desire to take upon you the name of Christ. As you reflect on the words shared earlier today by Sister Rachel Millett and Sister here, Lauren Anderson, on the gift of the Holy Ghost, know that you have a wonderful opportunity of growth in the gospel, and that you won't be doing it alone. The loving, tender, kind mercy Jesus Christ will be with you as you engage in your reading and studying of Scripture, as you personally pray daily and on any occasion, and petition your Father in heaven. Know
know that both your Father in heaven and your Savior Jesus Christ will be there in your kingdom. And likewise, as you listen to and heard the words of experience of Sister Lori Anderson, the gift of the Holy Ghost will be yours to walk with every day of your life. And the Holy Ghost is just as Sister Anderson has shared, a prompting spirit. That when you might find yourself at the precipice and making a decision that probably is not the right one, the Holy Spirit can whisper to you to walk with God. As you're seeking guidance and direction from your Father in heaven through prayer, and desirous of making a righteous decision, the companionship of the Holy Ghost can confirm in your heart and your spirit the things that you should undertake in people. It's a wonderful opportunity for you to now become part of the Nemesis Apple branch here in this city of Redfield. Please open your heart and open your mouth and welcome others into your world, as in the ensuing Sundays and hopefully not too far distant future, other activities that will be able to in larger numbers engage in. Allow these other wonderful youth, young men and young women, to be there with and for you to help walk you along this path of the gospel of Christ. We bless you, Sister Prue, with help, with righteous desires and an open, welcoming heart to know the full function of the gospel. This is a wonderful day, and it's so beautiful to see it shared by your family here as well. Go forth, Sister Prue. Be loving and engaging in this gospel. And as our Father in heaven understands and sees who and where you are in your life, know that his love and companionship belongs to you. Know this confirmation and these words of blessing and love, we close in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Normally we would do the handshake to welcome
you. I know. I heard it was you're supposed to bump elbows or something.
I wasn't sure. Yeah, we can do that after. But it's so good to be here with you all today. And like I mentioned, it's cold and it's reminding us that winter is about to knock our door here. It's beautiful to be in this building and feel and sense the spirit that's here, with someone who's desirous of opening their heart and be more welcoming and engaging in Christ. And as the branch president, I do have an opportunity to just share some words of welcome to Emily. And Emily, what I want to do is to bring to our attention a beautiful scripture that's found in the New Testament. It's found in Ephesians chapter 2, and it's just beautiful words of the Apostle Paul. From the New Testament times, and these verses are in chapter 2, verses 19 and 20. And it reads, Now therefore ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and the household of God, and are built upon the foundations of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. So, Emily, in the first few Sundays and activities you may have come here, you may have felt, I'm not so sure that this is the world I'm supposed to be a part of, or you know, how I adjusted to all these people here and around me, and they were strangers. And you to us to an extent was a bit of a stranger. But you're not. You're now wonderfully baptized in the Church of Christ, and you are no longer a stranger, but you're a fellow citizen here in the faith and love and fellowship. So in the ensuing weeks, we look forward to getting to know you more. One thing that's beautiful about this Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is where we're a not a paid clergy kind of setting. There's wonderful opportunities for every member to render service and be engaged in fulfilling opportunities of service here in the church. So we're getting to know you more, providing you an opportunity in the ensuing weeks and months. I want you to know that, like Sister Anderson, and to share with all of you that are here, let me think now. It was 1981. So how long ago was that?
40 years ago.
40 years ago. So you're older in the gospel than I am. 40 years ago, I made a decision just like you, Emily, to make a pretty significant life correction. And welcome into my heart the fullness of Christ and the desire to know more fully His Spirit and His love and our Father in Heaven's guidance and comfort. And in the blink of an eye, 4 years have smoked by. But I know no more now than I did then how much I love this gospel of Jesus Christ. That God loves us and is desirous of being there for us and helping us to be the best and the fullest of a person that we can be. And yeah, we'll think things, we'll say things, and we'll do things, and we go, ah, that's not really me. I don't want that to be me. And it's the sacrifice of Christ, this atonement, that allows us to pray to our Father in Heaven in Christ and to ask for forgiveness and understanding and direction and assistance. And as we lovingly ask, He will lovingly answer. And that is our hope and prayer as you join us in our fellowship now, that you'll know that beautiful presence of your Father in Heaven and your Savior, Jesus Christ, and that we can be united in your way forward and living and loving and serving in a great community and in faith. And I share this with you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Okay, 98.
Thank you, Steve.
Heavenly Father, we're very grateful for this opportunity that we had to witness the baptism of Emily. And we're very grateful for the decision that she's made to become a member of this church. And help her to be able to feel the confirmation from the Spirit of the truthfulness of this church and the correctness of what she's done. We're grateful for the Spirit that we've been able to feel during this baptism. We've been able to feel it in so much abundance. And help us to continue to feel the Spirit as we go through our the rest of our day. And help us be able to all continue to become strengthened in the truthfulness of this church. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Awesome. Yes, there are refreshments at the